Hi, I'm Brandon Abad. This is my presentation for Finance 653. We took the three industries, which were renewable energy, oil and gas, and information technology. We looked at five companies from each one, break them down over 5 years. First, we're going to talk about renewable energy. First company is going to be First Solar, Inc. NextEra Energy is the next one. Then we have SunPower, Tesla, and SolarCity. We're going to look at First Solar first. They design and manufacture and also sell modules that convert sunlight into solar energy. We're going to look at their ratios, five-year averages. The current ratio being 3.25, quick ratio of 1.97, and the cash ratio is 1.62. So what that tells us is that they have a lot of inventory, and also they're pretty solvent. They're not going to have any problems paying off short-term debts, but are they profitable? If you look at it a little closer, I would say that they're not. So their profit margin and ROE are both declining. The current ratio is increasing, most likely from increased inventory. The company is having difficulty selling its inventory, though. Within the industry, most companies, I think, are. It's just not something that people are willing to really invest in at the moment. So that's why inventory turnover would be slowing over the past 5 years. We have a decreasing ROA, which is also dragging down the ROE. Next, we're going to look at NextEra Energy. They generate both wind and solar energy. They're a Fortune 200 energy company with $17 billion in revenue. They have affiliates, the world's largest generator of wind and solar energy. NextEra Energy's ratios will look somewhat similar, except for the current ratio being 0.68. Financial leverage is 3.77, so you see they're borrowing a good bit. ROA being 3.37. The inventory turnover is 4.75. And profit margins are going to be 14.69, where ROE is 12.71. So you see they're not very liquid. They don't keep a lot of cash on hand. And that may be a problem in the short term. They may run into some problems paying their debt. They are profitable. So ROE is pretty consistent, and the profit margins have increased. So they're doing a good job with efficiency, making sure to keep costs down, and making some money off the products that they're selling. They managed to keep ROE up, even as inventory and asset turnover have been declining. They have a high amount of leverage, but it is consistent. It's not the cause of profits. So how have they done it? The numbers would indicate that, like I said, they're being very efficient in their operations, keeping costs down, and making some money off the products. So next we're going to look at SunPower Corp. They deliver complete solar energy solutions to residential and commercial customers. Their current ratio over the past 5 years is 1.98. Financial leverage is 3.14, which has been pretty consistent, somewhere in the threes. They have an inventory turnover of 7.12, which is looking pretty nice. But profit margins, ROE, and ROA, all negative. So they're selling a lot. Their inventory turnover is very high. They're selling a lot, but they're not making money off of what they're selling. It tells us there's a problem with efficiency in the company. So their cash ratio declined 50% in the past 5 years. That's most likely because they started to pay off some of their debts. They're not keeping as much cash on hand so that they can get rid of some of the leverage. They're currently solvent, but they might have trouble in the near future based on the fact that they're spending all this money getting rid of cash to cover their debts, is why that is. They have low profits and ROE caused by poor asset efficiency and amplified by the large amount of debt that we talked about. Next we have Tesla. Tesla designs and develops electronic vehicles as well as solar energy storage systems. Here we see this mega facility that Tesla's working on. That's something new and exciting in the industry that they expect to bring in a lot of money for them, and I think we're going to see by the numbers that the investors think so too. The current ratio is 1.52. Financial leverage is 4.88, Profit margins negative 50, ROA negative 76, and ROE negative 76, and ROA negative 22. So the current ratio is above one, but barely, and it's declining every year. It could be a sign that in the very near future they're not going to be profitable whatsoever, according to the numbers. So they're having a lot of the same issues as SunPower, where they have poor asset efficiency coupled with a high amount of debt, which is causing their ROE to be very low. Although the numbers might indicate that they're not profitable, stock prices are really high, which means that investors seem to think that they have something big coming in the future. It might have something to do with that complex they're building. Maybe people are seeing big things coming from that. So we have ROE, ROA, and the profit margin are all below zero, all in the negatives, but they have been improving since 2010. Again, investors see a bright future. Next, we're gonna look at SolarCity Corp. They design, manufacture, and install, and also sell solar energy systems to residential and commercial customers. SolarCity's current ratio is 1.19, financial leverage pretty high at 8. Inventory turnover is 1.21, so not moving a ton of inventory. ROA is negative 0.18, right below 1, and ROE being 3.22. That's probably really coming from that high financial leverage. And then profit margins being negative 16 tells us that, again, the product that they're selling is not very profitable, and they're probably not doing very good being efficient. So the SolarCity, we see that their current ratio is okay. They shouldn't have any trouble meeting their short-term obligations. They'll be able to pay their short-term debts. Seemingly profitable, but if we look closer, you can kind of question it. ROA is low. Most years it's been in the negatives. Any profits are most likely resulting from large amounts of leverage, as I said before. So if we look at the industry as a whole, the companies we selected from this industry are all over the place, some profitable, some not, some trending up, some trending down. Most are pretty solvent and won't have too many problems paying off short-term debts, and several of them have a high amount of debt, resulting in amplified losses and ROEs. Again, taking on a lot of debt and not having a lot of cash on hand, that's gonna bring those up. All right, so we're looking at the industry ROAs. You see them all pretty much jumbled together. I just think that the industry as a whole is not extremely profitable right now, maybe moving toward being profitable in the future, but at the moment, you see them all kind of struggling at the bottom there. Looking at ROE, same story. See SunPower kind of had some success a few years ago, but now right back down with the pack. Profit margins, same up until very recently. The projections going into 2018 have some companies going up, some going down. Again, most staying right in the middle. So our favorite company from this industry, although the investors don't seem to agree, the PE ratio is not the best out of all of them, but we're gonna go with NextEra. They have the highest ROE at 12.71. The profit margin has been increasing in the past 5 years. They've managed to keep the ROA high, even with declining asset turnover. And we see this as a sign that management's doing something right. Even though the industry is kind of struggling right now, these guys are still able to be profitable. Next, we're gonna look at the oil and gas industry. We're gonna look at five companies again. First, which is gonna be Phillips 66, and then we have Tesoro, Par Petroleum, Marathon, and Halliburton. So we're gonna look at Phillips 66 first. They are an energy manufacturing and logistics company. They do midstream refining and chemical capabilities. This is just a quick look at the history of Phillips 66. They had merged with ConocoPhillips at one point, and then separated again. Now they're mainly downstream. So we're gonna look at the five-year ratios. The current ratio being 1.38, financial leverage 2.15, inventory turnover 33.73, profit margins 2.56, ROE is 15.71 and ROA is 7.43. So you see those numbers on par with the financial leverage. Current ratio is not great, but it is consistent. Solvency is not an issue with them. They're able to pay their short-term debts. ROA is declining each of the past 5 years. It was 3.1 the past 2 years. Financial leverage is increasing in each of the past 5 years. That's most likely to combat the decline in asset efficiency of the company. It doesn't look like it is effective. The profit margin and the ROE have both been declining for Phillips 66. Next, we're going to look at Tesoro. They're an independent petroleum refining, logistics, and marketing company. Tesoro's current ratio is 1.62. ROE is 15.24. ROA is 4.9. And profit margin is 2.33 with a leverage of 3.06. So again, you see most of these companies taking on a decent amount of debt, but also still being profitable. Their current ratio is pretty solid. Cash ratio is a little bit below one, but they do have a sufficient amount of cash on hand. Similar problems to Phillips 66, where the inventory turnover is causing ROA to drop significantly. Having increased leverage over the past 5 years to keep ROE up. Slightly more successful with this tactic than Phillips 66 has been. They've managed to keep ROE from falling too much. That's a sign of good efficiency in the company. Par Petroleum is next. They are involved in energy and infrastructure business. They have capabilities such as refining, retailing, and logistics. We're going to look at their ratios. Current ratio just above 1 at 1.03. Financial leverage is 2.87. Inventory turnover 12.45, moving a ton. Profit margin is negative in all the past 5 years. You see a negative ROA and ROE. ROE about three times worse. There you see the financial leverage is about three. Makes sense. So the current ratio is above one, but it is the worst of the five companies in the oil and gas industry that we studied. They're starting to see a trend with these companies having some problems, the same problems as the first two companies. However, Par Petro has not been able to weather the storm quite as well as the other ones that we looked at. Most likely this is due to poor turnover, and second lowest, the turnover was the second lowest of all of them. Marathon Petroleum is next. They're engaged in the refining, marketing, retail, and distribution of petroleum. They are the largest company of their kind east of the Mississippi. We're going to look at their ratios, 1.37, again, above 1, but not quite to 2. Financial leverage is about 3. Profit margins, 2.8. ROE is actually positive for Marathon, 18.66, as well as a positive ROA, 6.83. So judging from the numbers, we can see that they're solvent. They have no issues paying off their short-term debts. ROE is the highest of the five companies. Again, most of the other ones being negative, and this one being positive is a really good sign. Once again, we see the same story: increased leverage, trying to combat declining industry turnover. People are buying less gas, trying to save their money. You take your bike to work if you have to. Do what you got to do. Stuff gets expensive. So they managed to keep up ROE by keeping ROA up and also from increasing their leverage. This could cause trouble in the future as their projected ROA in the future is not very high. So if they're relying on that, it could be an issue. And finally, in this industry, we're gonna talk about Halliburton. They provide services and products that service the upstream oil and gas industry throughout the entire life cycle of the reservoir. Their current ratio is 2.95, definitely higher than the other ones. Financial leverage is a little bit less, but not much, at 2.11. Profit margin is negative, and ROE is going to be 0.31, and ROA 1.91, so pretty low ROE there. Current ratio is strong, but not much else good to say about Halliburton, really. They've managed to keep a low debt. Negative ROAs in the past 2 years have caused negative profit margins, though. Same issues as the other companies, really. Again, all the companies within this industry are kind of going with the pack. Right, so looking at the whole industry, all five companies are pretty solvent. They can meet their short-term debts, but they're all suffering from the same issue, is that the asset turnover is slowing down over time. Some of them have done a better job weathering the storm, some of them have sucked. So we're looking at industry ROE, again, most pretty consistent. Got Halliburton down there, they're struggling, they're not doing so well. ROA, pretty much the same, most consistent. A couple of them spiking, but you know, they've gone back up. Our favorite company out of the oil and gas industry would have to be Marathon. Although we're not too confident about any of them, the oil and gas industry is kind of struggling. Everyone's looking for different solutions, different ways to get around, different ways to power their businesses and homes. So the industry as a whole, we're kind of turning away from that. They have taken on more debt recently, all the companies, and managed to keep ROE up. Marathon has been the most successful at insulating themselves from the declining industry turnover, which seems to be plaguing everyone, like we talked about. Least favorite company, was close. All of them were pretty bad, particularly Par Petroleum and Halliburton. Both have negative ROEs, but at the end of the day, Par Petroleum was worse because they've not been able to stop incurring debt. They're losing money and not being able to pay it back. All right, so we're gonna move on to our final industry, which is the information technology industry. We did CACI International, Accenture, Amdocs, CGI Group, and Gartner. So first of all, we're gonna look at CACI. They simulate, simulation and information technology company is what they do. The primary customer is the US government, which is a good sign for anyone. Looking at their ratios, current ratio is 1.52, the financial leverage is 2.12, profit margin 3.89, ROE 10.76, ROA 5.17, and PE ratio is looking good, 13.22. So they're expected to do even better than they're doing now. Current ratio is looking good. Almost all the current assets are in receivables. They're not really a problem since federal government is their main customer. Again, if federal government wants you to do good, you're gonna do good. Be all right. ROE is declining in the past years. Declining ROA is most likely the reason for that. PE ratio continues to rise even though ROE is declining, a sign that investors still feel good. Again, when you have the federal government to back you, people feel pretty good about you. So next we're gonna look at Accenture. They provide both technology and management consulting services. They serve a variety of industries, including media and entertainment, as well as banks and government agencies. Here's just a look at where Accenture does business. You can see that there's not too many places that they don't have firms, not too many places where they're really out of touch. We've got the little picture. Apparently, they know how good they're doing too. Says who says you can't be big and nimble? They have a pretty good idea of how they're looking. Current ratio is 1.41. Financial leverage is 3.51. Profit margin 9.55. ROE through the roof at 60.5. ROA 17.55. And PE ratio is looking nice too at 17.78. Apparently, people think that they're going to step it up and do even better than they're doing now. So their current ratio is good. Again, mostly receivables, but cash ratio is pretty strong too. They shouldn't have a problem paying short-term debts. Extremely high ROE, but it is declining in each of the past 5 years, even though ROA has been increasing. This is due most likely to decreasing debt. Financial leverage is down. They're not borrowing quite as much as they used to. And then the falling ROE, it's not really an issue since ROA is up. The ROE most likely is just down because they have less debt, which really isn't a problem at all. The company has simply been reducing debt. Next, we're going to look at Amdocs. They develop and implement software associated with business and operational support systems. They provide tailored information to technology services. Amdocs' current ratio is 1.89, just below 2. Financial leverage, pretty low at 1.51. Profit margin is 11.59, ROE 12.12, and ROA being 8.04. So the current ratio is good. They have plenty of cash to pay their debts. ROA is good, projected to be even better the next year. They have managed to keep their ROE high, even with the very little debt. They're making money without having to borrow a whole lot. So the interest coverage ratio is actually 289, which is extremely high. They could probably afford to use some of that liquid cash that they have and get actually some more debt so they could improve their future. CGI Group is the next one. They manage information technology services as well as business process services. They provide end-to-end IT services. Here we have a list of a few CEOs within the industry. You can see how each CEO is affecting its company, the rating that he carries. The one for CGI right up here at the top with 92%. So apparently he's adding a lot of economic value to his company. CGI Group's current ratio is just below 1. Financial leverage 2.22. Profit margin 8.17. ROE 15.44. And ROA 7.36, 39, I'm sorry. PE ratio is just as good as a lot of their competitors. Whole industry looks to be looking up. Theirs is 16.04. So the current ratio is low, and they have very little cash. The inventory turnover is fairly high, though, so there might not be too much of an issue. They're incurring debt, but they're kind of paying it off just as fast as they're incurring it. So it's not really an issue. But it could be. They've managed to reduce their long-term debt over the past 3 years and keep ROE consistent. Nothing really stands out. They're not bad or good in any particular category, but they are solid overall. Finally, we're going to look at Gartner. They're an information technology research and advisory company. They work with clients to research, analyze, interpret the business of information technology. Here's just a little sample of something that Gartner does. Some work that they put out. It's called the Digital Marketing Hype Cycle. Just something that they provide for companies. So Gartner's current ratio is just below 1. Not a whole lot of cash on hand, but probably enough. Their financial leverage is through the roof, actually, at 38. Profit margin 8.75. ROE 66.2, but that's probably. You can explain that away looking at their financial leverage, ROA 9.37. Current ratio is not good. Solvency could be a concern, especially when you look at the high amount of long-term debt that they're incurring. And if you don't have a lot of liquidity in your company to pay some of that off, I mean, it's just going to keep building and building. Profit margins and ROE are both very good, but clearly a product. Again, of the financial leverage that they have. So, looking at the whole industry, current ratios are all close to 1. Not one of them are above 2. It's very common in service industries. They're not carrying a lot of inventory or really any at all. They're just providing a service. Almost all of them are doing pretty well, which is not surprising considering that the service that they provide is in high demand as media, social media, and coverage of everything going on in the world grows rapidly, so is this industry. Something that's, in the future probably just going to get more and more used. So they have very strong PE ratios, which again tells you that the industry as a whole has a pretty bright future. And then, again, the industry is booming, not going anywhere anytime soon. Our favorite company out of these. It was difficult to pick because most of them were doing so good, but we're going to go with Amdocs because they were able to keep such a low leverage, such a low amount of short-term debt, but at the same time keep their ROE very consistent and very high. This means they have increased their financial leverage, but we actually think that, again, that they should incur more debt and because using other people's money to make money is less expensive than using your own money. So if they could take some of that liquid cash that they have and you know, turn it into some leverage, that could actually make their stock do very well. Our least favorite company would have to be Gartner. This was pretty easy considering they have so much long-term debt and almost no cash to pay it off. They have a very high ROE and profit margins.